Haku, haku. My name is Christopher Diaz, Tadai Diaz. I'm a Chumash, Toho no Oatam, and Mayo. I'm out here today gathering with my daughter, Michaela, and my sister, Lenore. And I'm here also with wonderful people from Monrovia Park. And they've given us an opportunity today to come out here and gather what we call cochineal. It's a small bug that lives off cactus, wild cactus. And as it grows, it creates a little tiny web, and a lot of people believe that it's like a fungus that's infecting their cactus. When in reality, it's a small bug that comes out. It lands on the cactus. It's like a little fly looking thing. Lays its eggs, and as it grows, it becomes this little tiny bug. And what we do is we harvest these bugs. They've been harvested for thousands of years up and down North America. It'll normally be attributed to Mexico. Indigenous tribes from Mexico, and then later on when Spain came, they kind of took it globally and introduced it to the rest of the world. As we gather it, you'll see that it kind of has this white ashy look, this fluff to it. It's a very delicate bug. This is the cocoons that it's actually made around its little bug that's in there, the little tiny larva that's in there. And as what we do is we harvest it. We dry it out because we want to be able to use it in the future. And so we'll harvest it, and when we do, we'll dry it out, and we will end up with these after they're all cleaned, where all the white cocoon is taken off and then they're dried out. And then we end up with these little tiny bugs. And this is what's inside those white fluffs. Later on, when we're ready to use them for our dyes, we crush them up, we rehydrate them, and it creates a beautiful red dye. And depending on the amount of bugs and how the soil is and how the cactus is growing, you'll get everything from a very like a bluish color to a very dark red. And we used it for a lot of different dyes, for dyeing a lot of our plant matter for our baskets, dyeing other materials like porcupine quill, porcupine hair, hair from our deer when we're making different portions of our regalia. It's something that's still widely used now. You'll find it in lipstick, you'll find it in women's makeup, rouge. Anything that has a red dye, you will more than likely find cochineal animal being used in there. I'm a Native American monitor for both Tongva, since we are on Tongva land, and I wanna make sure that we acknowledge that we've been brought out here. We are on Tongva land. And I thank the people and their ancestors for allowing us to be out here today. I'm a native monitor for them. I'm an activist within the Tongva people and my own people, Chumash. Protecting lands, you know, protect Pavungna, you know. And this is kind of like what we do. We kind of keep our old traditions alive, our customs, our ceremonies. We're in the process of keeping, of rebirthing our language. And recapturing a lot of our old ways. And again, you know, we're very thankful for Monrovia for allowing us to come out here and do this and harvest like we did thousands and thousands of years. We've been doing, never stopped. We just don't get the opportunity to do it as much anymore. But it's something that we're still very active with doing, which is protecting and continuing our old ways.